Good evening. Good evening, everybody. And thank you all for coming tonight. And those who haven't already done so, there's plenty of time to get lucky before dawn. Dawn, the beginning of everything. But before dawn, there was the Betty Page look-alike contest. A celebration of an unobtainable goddess of the screen, a beautiful lady who was one of the first to tastefully remove her clothes on camera in front of a long lens and a rapidly swelling audience. She was honored yearly at Dragoncon by female contestants appearing on stage in a state of undress and male members of the audience appearing in a state of excitement. The girls would exotically strut their homage to Betty, the epitome of the alluring but unobtainable virgin. Some years ago, the contest was brought to an end since the girls had a problem appearing unobtainable. And nobody in Atlanta could quite remember just what a virgin was. But that display of beauty and grace and succulent flesh made Dragoncon what it is today. A cesspit. That tribute has been replaced by tonight's celebration of the human body. The human body with breasts. I'm sorry, who laughed? Who laughed? Sorry, somebody laughed. Who? You. Come here. Name?
My name is Ost. Seriously.
A?
No. Age?
Age.
I am 21 years old.
Thank you. Sex?
No.
Yes or no will do. It's going to be one of those evenings. What did you say your name was? Asked. Well, go and sit on it. You find the word breast amusing, do you? No doubt you would go completely mad at the word nipple. I see you brought your family along with you, Ask. Very, very strange. Must be something in the water here. Well, please try and restrain yourself during the course of this evening. I know it'll be hard for you. As I was saying, tonight's celebration of the human body with breasts, known to most of us as women, but to obviously some of the men in the audience, as a hustler centerfold and a man-sized box of Kleenex. Why else are they called man-sized? Anyway, so now we honor another goddess with the Dawn Lookalike contest. And I regret to say that in the past, this event has suffered from audiences of a shockingly low and vulgar mentality. As I look around tonight, I can see it is clearly no exception. But we'll go ahead anyway. So, as we thrill to the parade of perfect bodies in the galaxy, I want you to enjoy the way they look. And of course, we start with one of the most perfect bodies in the galaxy, my own. see before you paraded magnificent specimens of their type. An ass, if you get out of your seat, you're a dead man. Others who are allowed a closer look are, of course, the judges, who will join with me in looking at these visions of pulchritude and silicone. And so, perhaps I might now take a moment to introduce them. And first of all, I am proud to introduce the first place winner of the Dawn Contest 1999, Miss Cindy Gores. Thank you very much. Thank you, Cindy. Thank you for coming tonight.
Thank you for having me tonight.
And she looks such a lady, doesn't she? Do you think you're going to find it hard to do this job?
Absolutely.
Does it bring back some of that nervous excitement that you had when you were a contestant?
I'm a woman, aren't we always nervous?
Well, I was wondering how the girls feel backstage, so I...
I bet you are.
It's a tough crowd. Do you think you can handle them?
Oh, I believe I can handle all of them.
I think you'd better sit down. And of course, Cindy is not on her own, because I would like to introduce somebody who is no stranger to this stage at all herself. Because I want to now introduce the first place winner of the 2000 Dawn Contest, Tracy Carter. Well, Tracy, I didn't quite know what to say, or indeed where to say it. I think you could have come dressed for the part, don't you?
I couldn't find a thing to wear.
Clearly in certain areas. But how very nice. And PVC is in this year?
It never goes out of style.
It never goes out of style. What will you be looking for in the contestants tonight?
Not so much in what they're wearing, but how they wear it, I think.
Well, for myself, I will be looking for what they're not wearing. But I wish you lots of luck with judging. It's a tough job, but somebody has to do it. Thank you very much. Which brings us on to our third judge, and here again, no stranger to this appalling sequence of events, Ava Hopkins, art assistant and office goddess for Dawn and Mr. Linsman. Ava.
Again.
I am fine.
That's great.
What is it like to be facing this
salivating mom?
Yes.
It's great. I love them.
All of them?
Oh, yes.
At the same time?
If possible.
I hope there are no children in here tonight. Now, you are going to be, you really join a very highly qualified bunch of panelists. What will you be looking for in the girls?
A real goddess.
A real goddess.
Someone who carries herself and knows that she is woman.
She is woman. Total
yes.
Woman. Okay.
Yep.
Will you be looking for some kind of performance beyond the costume?
Generally, an attitude.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
Confidence
mm-hmm.
with a hint of vulnerability, creativity.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Vulnerability, that sounds cute.
Yes, doesn't it?
can we talk about that later?
Sure.
Very nice. Yes. And of course, none of us would be here tonight. None of us would be here tonight without the imagination, the strange, perverted mind that is Mr. Linsman.
Why, thank you, sir.
Pleasure. So...
Me?
The man who reinvented woman.
So
what are your feelings to be here again?
Oh, it feels great. Feels amazing. Mm-hmm. There are some fantastic looking women back there, true goddesses.
We've had a little preview, haven't we?
Us, yeah.
Yeah. You know, we've been... Well, you more than me. I mean, you were really previewing there.
In my hotel room, or you mean?
Oh, you did a pre-preview. Oh, yeah. What's it like to be responsible for all this?
eh. No. It's pretty awe-inspiring. You know?
Pretty awe-inspiring. And you know, you've given out this beautiful creation, Dawn.
Do you feel safe in that house?
Yeah. I have no choice.
Fortunately, they have big hands and they can give you one now. Mr. Lizard, go!
So, now the fun can begin. I should point out that we may need to impose a sense of discipline here. The British are very keen on discipline, you may know. Mm-hmm. Especially our politicians. Do you realize our parliament is run by the chief whip? Seriously? Your government seems to be run using a cigar as discipline. Well, I think it's interesting that you have a Bush as president. Mind you, our Prime Minister is a complete prick. But just in case anybody has any ideas, be warned, we will be taking a vote on it later. So now on to the dignified part of the evening. Please work at it. Our first contestant, our first entrant, our first Dawn lookalike is, and please give a very, very big welcome to Pandora Hall, one of the youngest Dawn contestants ever. Hiya, come on then. Oh, yeah. Would you like to lift her up the stairs? Here we go. Oh, hi, Pandora. Can you wave to the audience? Come this way a little. Can you wave over here? Okay. So, do you have anything to say to the audience? Ah, that's terrific. I think that's probably the most sense anybody will speak here tonight. Okay. I think she may need a little help to get off the stage now. Okay, a big hand for, I think you better pick her up there. Okay. Yo! Okay. And now, contestant number one. Please welcome, representing Cry for Dawn, Deborah Abbott. Deborah is dressed to please and tease in her rendition of Cry for Dawn. The black-gloved beauty will capture your soul while dressed in black wings, black leather, a skull, and a smile. She can make man, woman, or beast ride on. Isn't she lovely? Oh, wow. Oh, and that's only the beginning of the show, folks. So, do you have anything you'd like to say? You said you
I love you.
Thank you. Well, how very spectacular. All of it. Is this all your own work?
Yes, it is.
Can I help?
Sure. You can help me do anything.
Ladies and gentlemen, your first contestant. Wow. now, please welcome our next entrant, Janeth Harbour. She is the essence of dawn.
Much faster.
Is there anything special you would like to tell us about the skull and crossbone? I don't know if you can see this here. Yeah? Is that like a death zone? What?
Could be good, could be bad.
Oh, so we could try that. Right. Well, there we have. What do you think? Give it a twirl. Whoa, thank you very much. And now, we present Amber Baldwin. And you can very quickly... Amber Baldwin! Thank you. Thank you, Amber. Wow, she can make the feathers fly. Rough around Thanksgiving, though, watch it. And now, please welcome Dawn from drama, Larissa Beckerman. Every woman has a goddess within her. It takes the right attitude and a little creativity to bring it forth. The pieces of this costume in their virgin form belong to a prom princess. But just with a little effort, you see the goddess within. Just as Dawn is the goddess of birth and rebirth, we all have the power to bring from the ashes something bright and new. I think we should take a closer look here. Yes? A little twirl? Cool. And suspenders are in this yet? Oh, little wrinkle. We have to leave. Excuse me. Thank you. And now, Sarah Pope, leather and lace. Watch out for this one. Where it ends?
Yeah.
No more?
No.
More?
No.
You shut up. Thank you very much. Beautiful. And now, Dawn is the epitome of what every woman wishes to be. Intelligent, sexy, beautiful, confident, all with the ability to kick ass. Thank you for Dawn, Joe. She means more to us than you will ever know. Cry Dawn, cry for Dawn. Welcome Susan Kurdash. You've got to be brave in this job. We both lie silently still in the dead of the night. Her breasts are covered with skulls. We both lie close to She's walking towards me. I'm a little afraid. Was it something Yo! Susan Turdak! Thank you! Thank you, Susan! Way to go! And now, Dawn from Fall of Anything, please welcome Jamie Jessup. Well, it had to happen. something. Well, as I was saying, tell me something. Your costume is entirely made of leaves. What happens in winter?
If I have the right person to keep me warm, nothing.
And how long did it take to make this costume?
With the help of some good friends, it took about 20 minutes and a hell of a lot of safety pins.
And we may be using these safety pins in a minute to put it back together. So, people, you can do this at home. I know you do already, yes. Put your hand down. No. Thank you very much. Wow. And now please welcome contestant number 8, back in black, Beth Hendrickson. Whoa. Dawn has been portrayed in a variety of ways, from the girl next door to the embodiment of the goddess mother herself. Here we see the complex and ethereal Dawn looking very cute in a hand-crafted capsule with an inlay of her classic green scarlet. She also has her signature chain and rose. She appeared in the outfit on the cover of Dawn, the Genesis edition. Ladies and gentlemen, Beth Hendrickson. Excellent. Now, silence, if you will. Dawn can be many things, but most of all, she embodies the perfection of womanhood. This is my idea of how Dawn would look in our modern world. She is a chameleon, constantly changing with the times and ideals of feminine perfection, yet always remaining true to her own strengths and personal beauties. This is Dawn for the modern age, presented by Joy Martin. And now, please welcome Sherry Flight. It all started years ago, says Sherry, when I introduced myself to the woman at the comic book store. She exclaimed and scurried off. She returned with a copy of a comic with my name in it. I am Dawn from the inside cover of Drama. I have created a number of Dawn outfits. I am enamored with Joseph Lindzen's wonderful work. I have broken out of the roses and change to create an outfit especially for this contest. Although permanently marked with tears, although permanently marked with tears, this Dawn is strong and vivacious, making an unforgettable appearance in her first Dragoncon. This goddess of birth and rebirth gives a new life to Dragoncon's annual Dawn lookalike. She'll turn heads with her natural beauty. And watch this space. Ladies and gentlemen, Jamie Clark. Wow. Just a little frightened there. Dawn goes to Japan with Jennifer Rice. Konnichiwa. Wow. Remember, I am fluent in over 6 million forms of communication. Okay, that was out. Shut up. JC1701 has dorned the dorm or sob. You decide. Husbands, remember she is a goddess. You can look, but you can't order off the menu. Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Colley. And now please welcome Daphne DeMella, Angelic Dawn. To capture the softer side of Dawn, this costume was created slowly from the inside out. The foundation is an ivory satin corset and floor-length hoop. From there, a four-panel tapestry on the skirt and matching ruffled underskirt were added. For the top, a modified sleeve bodice was used with a tight neckline and hip covering. Wings were then formed with aluminum wire and silk. The dress was finished off with gloves and a chain and rows of trademarks of the one. Ladies and gentlemen, Daphne DeMella. Beautiful. As Dawn walks out of the shadow, she continues searching, hoping that this search will finally be the last. Please welcome Monica Greathouse as Dawn number 4. Wow.
Have what I'm looking for?
Not you. I'll sit down. You sit down. Honey, she ain't that desperate. You just keep it in your pants.
There you go. That's you.
And now Trisha Buchwald, the winter goddess. As the seasons change, the goddess is reborn anew. This is Miss Trisha as the winter. Don't do that, they'll come up on stage. Okay, hate these people. Oh, look at that. All those chains. See me afterwards. And now I believe we have Rachel Shelton. Mm-hmm. Yes. Dawn to Rachel is the visualization of life force. She is the balance and foil of death. Yet life must also love death, for without the one, the other cannot exist. Maiden, mother, crone, she is all. The costume is simple, representing the life force, the goddess, in each of us. Hey, I ain't no goddess, you know what I mean. Jennifer Isabel, costume, Dawn the Forest, hand sewn and supervised by the cat. Some. Despite this, it was finished on time. Look at that. Pretty. Yeah, cool. Very nice. Jennifer Isbell. Yeah. Thanks, Jennifer.
Okay. I love you.
Oh, cute. And now, Jackie Labitar. The goddess comes to us in many forms. Watch your mouth. And this is her most beautiful, her most natural Wow.
Yeah.
Oh. There's people here.
Oh.
Just watch it. What would you say to this crowd of marauding Philistines?
Take a good look.
Oh, I did. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much. Jackie, yeah. Oh. Audrey Stewart. Audrey Stewart. Whoa, oh, sinister. Here we have the essence of Dawn. Whoa. Okay, nice one, Audrey. And now, thank you, Audrey. And now, Kelly Pendleton. Dreams of Dawn, and I know you do. Whoa. So, Kelly, I have to ask you, what are your hobbies?
Killing, going to heaven, hell, you know.
Mm-hmm. You don't mind. You can rest on my arm. Don't worry about it. Well, what do you think of this crowd?
I've seen bigger.
They seem good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. What do you think your chances of impressing the judges are here?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. They're all smiling.
So many girls.
I think they're on drugs.
Mm. Well, okay. You know, Joe.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know you're wearing pretty high heels here. I'll just, yeah, go sit down. Kelly Pendleton. Oh. Something after my own heart here. Autumn Skyport with White Trash comic cover. From Richmond, Virginia, Autumn Skyport is portraying the White Trash Dawn comic. She's a She is a former Hawaiian Tropic model, Best Butt in Richmond winner. Yo. Thank you so much.
I'd just like to say, I'd like to welcome you to Fantasy Island.
Thank you.
I did White Trash in honor of my favorite TV show, Jerry Springer. Here's to you, Jerry, if you're watching.
Yeah. Beautiful. So thank you, White Trash, Anna Skyports. And now, please wear Laura Lammers. Laura is president of the Cybernuts, Inc. and director of a poetbox.com, a member of the Knoxville Association of some Women, lots of stuff, and she's looking pretty sexy to me. Oh.
You know, I wanted to ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
Is it true that you have a better power source than most men?
It depends if I've been recharged lately. Do you want to recharge me after the show.
No!
Oh, what was it? A little rehearsal here. Okay. Oh, look at that. And this is a chief executive businesswoman. Don't you love big business? Oh, bribery of the judges. And now, Pamela Gentry, an original costume of Dawn.
The goddess would like to speak.
Of course.
It was so... It was so hot backstage.
It's pretty hot here. Is that it? Cool. Well done, thank you. That was very, very exciting. Cool. And now Dawn Emanuel, inside cover of Dream. It all started years ago when I was introduced by a woman in a comic book store. She ran and she brought a comic book cover, and here I am. Wow. Very, very nice. Thank you. There you go. And now please welcome Jane Horvath with the six skulls. Jane is wearing her own handmade rendition of the six skulls print. Whoa. In flowing lavender, this longtime Dawn fan embodies the softer side of the goddess. Woo! Whoa, my favorite color. Well, it is now. Thank you very much. And now, Sabrina Tragus, Lucifer's Halo Dawn. The most important part of being a goddess is knowing how to enjoy it yourself. It's strange in a beautiful world if you open up to it.
Want to go have some trouble, sugar?
Fine, good, cool, lost for words. Caroline Salt, an original Dawn portrayal, presenting on stage, Caroline Salt. Whoa, way to go. Recovered. Good recovery. Yeah. Oh, nearly. Excuse me. Just say that. I need to look for it. I live my life. Very nice. Very nice. I like that. Thank you very much. Millicent Aldi, Dawn Purity. Here comes Millicent. Here she comes. She comes. She comes. Purity. Truth. Beauty. She is drama. She is life. The goddess revealed. Ain't that pretty? Wow. Hush your mouth. And now as we draw nearly to a conclusion, Megan McHugh, an original creation. Dawn is class, style, and sexuality. She is sexy without being trashy. I'll say that again. She is sexy. She is sexy without being trashy. And she is bold and strong while maintaining her feminine side. Dawn is every woman something they should aspire to. Beautiful, beautiful. Megan McHugh. Thank you. And now, May Colwake, Crimson Vengeance Day. Wow. Oh!
On the side, I'm a contortionist in a freak show. Do you want a little taste?
No! 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 Do you want a taste? Do you really want a taste? Do you really, really want a taste? Give him a taste! Oh! No, I can do that. Beautiful! Whoa. Well, that was worth waiting for. And now I believe through sheer exhaustion we come to our last contestant, Sarah Falls, an original costume from Dawn. Yeah. come to baby. Come to mama. You know, I used to be a serious actor.
You're doomed.
Thank you very much. And now, due to a total screw-up by Dragoncon, somebody who's going to rattle her chains with me?
Yes, someone tried to forget about me.
Oh, honey, I never forgot about you. Come.
Of course you can.
Black chains.
I happen to be the creativity and the muse that is Dawn. Mm-hmm. I am the image that will tickle the back of your brain. My chains will wrap around you as you try to capture my essence and my image.
Don't stop.
But... more. Well, I can only promise you this. The harder you struggle, the better your rewards. Oh.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there we have it. It's obviously very clear why one on these occasions speaks from behind a podium. We're cool now. I checked. Yeah, cool. So now the judges have a very, very difficult job appraising this display excuse me. Just pretend that nothing unusual is happening. What? Oh, we do that now. No, we don't want to see them again. Oh, no, we don't. Listen, I got jet lag. You don't want to see the girls again. Do you want to see the girls again? Do you really want to see the girls again? Do you really, really want to see the girls again? Yeah! Here come the girls! Yeah! Keep hollering. Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah, real fast. Yes. Ah. Well, now, of course, the judges have the extraordinarily difficult task of finding out who are going to be the four prize winners in tonight's contest. So, three prize, that's deflation, the three prize winners. And so now you have a few minutes to play with yourselves to talk amongst yourselves in the audience. And now possibly is a good time to come and meet some of you, if that's all right. I am going to walk amongst you. Please, please don't get too exciting. Excited. Touching is $10, but no tongues, okay? No, I told you before, no tongues. Okay, so, not at the first one? For 20 tongues, okay. Yeah. Okay, now, because I will be wanting to know what you the public, you the masses, think. What is your popular? Yeah, what would you be, oh, is it 20, but... What is your name?
Jason.
Yes, quite. So Jason, stand up if you would. What was it that made you offer me $20?
I don't know, just for the hell of it.
Right. Next time, if you could shave, maybe it'll be a happening thing. So now, you're wearing a beautiful jacket. What would be your choice of tonight's...
I like the white angel.
The white angel.
Yeah, one of the last ones.
The Weiße Engel, yeah. Have you seen the film? Is it safe?
Yeah.
Good, cool. I like an educated audience. Well done. Good. The white. We need to bring the mic down, please. Right down. Good evening and welcome to Dragoncon. Here we are. A mixture of filth and sex and depravity. So, business as usual. Hey. Who else has an opinion on another contestant? Yes, sir, you were the hare. Stand up, please. Yeah, go. And the skull and crossbones, obviously a sensitive young man. What's in your mind? What, if anything, is in your mind?
I thought you were the best contestant.
That kid's a genius. Absolutely right. What a brilliant guy. He's obviously disguised as a nerd. He can't help because Well, I tell you, maybe standards are changing here at DragonCon. But who, apart from me, we've had the White Angel, and now who else are we thinking of here? Yes, sir.
I think the lady that was in the red leather outfit, I mean, really had the epitome of womanhood. She was, was her Hooters. I don't know what I was thinking.
You're drooling, sir. You're drooling now. Just wipe your mouth, okay? Wipe your mouth. It's really dangerous back here. Oh, look, I'm coming to the cheap seats, yes.
I think Miss Caroline Salt should win it.
Uh-huh. What was she giving us? Do you remember?
Oh, the beauty, the boots, the whip.
Uh-huh, everything.
You seem to like her with the magnifying glass.
Oh, absolutely true, but you know, as I get older, my eyesight's failing. I really have to, get closer.
Oh,
there.
But that's such a wonderful set of assets to see.
It is. Is anybody here who should have entered this costume contest and just was a little afraid? You're a very beautiful young lady, and you appear to be chained to the man next to you. Why is this?
We all have our hobbies.
You have your hobbies. Would you like to stand up? I don't know if we can see what your hobby is. Your hobby is holding a man in chains, and yours, dare I ask?
Whatever she wants.
Really? just between ourselves, what is the most, scary thing she's ever asked you to do?
None of it's been scary.
Oh. Okay, he doesn't want to frighten the audience. There's a lady dressed in the most virginal and pretty way. Why didn't you take part in this event?
They're beautiful.
So were you. Were you afraid of this howling mob of vulpine creatures?
No, not
ready
really.
Ready to make lewd comments?
Actually, no, I think it's a great audience.
You do? You should,
I think
you should
they had
be
a lot
where
of great
I was standing.
Contestants.
It seemed like trash to me.
Oh, yeah, a little bit of trash there. Yeah. And
now, behind you, I don't want to be scary,
actually,
but
wait.
Oh, excuse me, there's a little moment happening here. Oh, that was...
Everybody else got to.
Oh, that's really cool. But what is a little scary is, sitting behind you, is somebody who clearly needs no introduction, since he doesn't have a face. Are you in disguise, sir?
Well, this is a costume for Lord of the Rings. I was doing the role-playing today, and I figured I would do the dress-up as Sauron the Dark Lord for the evening entertainment.
Do you bump into things a lot?
Actually, you can see through this. It's not as...
It's a bit of a con, then.
Yes.
Sit down. Oh, now look, I thought I was in the cheap seats then. I'm in the pauper section. Ah! Oh, look, there's wide open spaces. Oh, gosh, and look. So now, you, look at you in the pretty stuff, and you've got a pig's head on a stick. I find that very attractive in a woman, yeah. Is this a little light lunch or what? So how come you're sitting in the trash seats?
Can't get anything better.
Oh, you can't, you say that. You just haven't hooked up with the right guy.
he's playing games right now.
All right, and is that a pig's head or, it's a dragon's head, stupid. Idiot. Of course it's a dragon head. And now, what a beautiful shirt. Wow.
Thank you.
You know, next time should we have, you know, for the ladies in the audience, here's the thing for DragonCon next year. Maybe there should be a male version of this. What do you think? Yeah? Okay, there you are. You heard it here first. So I get the copyright on it, right? Otherwise I sue dead. Yes. How are you doing here? Now you were just going to sleep there, weren't you? Yeah, you were going to sleep. I saw you. Watch it. So meanwhile, now I would like to take a moment I'm being accosted here. Something's happening that I thought I was out of control before. What?
Anthony Daniels.
Dare I ask?
This is at least the third trip to DragonCon. You are always working when we do our guest of honor presentations. I come to you. I wish to present you with a Guest of Honor Award from DragonCon. Thank you for making this a wonderful show. My friend.
Oh, cool. That's cool. And excellent. Oh, wow. Oh. Very nice. Thank you.
Hand carved in Vietnam.
Thank you. Oh, isn't that? Oh, I'm all moved to tears now. I'm very sad. Oh, I'm going. Oh yeah, where's the check?
This guy comes all the way from England. You can't give him a check.
Yeah.
How's he gonna pay for his plane ticket?
Yeah. I'm gonna have to stay here. I'm gonna have to do DragonCon the rest of my life. What a beautiful lady here. Why weren't you on stage in this contest? You've clearly come as a goddess of some kind.
The goddess of fertility and liberty and music, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Hathor.
Cool. Very nice, too. Any other goddesses of sex and fertility here at all? Sir, if you are a goddess of sex and fertility, you seem to be in severe disguise.
I'm Roland Duke.
You're a little new to it.
I honor sex and fertility.
You're a little new to the art of...
And drugs.
You're new to the art of sex and fertility. Cool. Right, good. Thank you. Long may it stay that way. Somebody wants to shake my... What do you want to shake? Oh, my hand. Oh, well, that's cool. Okay. Well, you can never be sure. And how pretty you look. Look at you. Look at you standing up there.
Hi. Yeah.
How are you doing?
Well, very well. Thank you.
Is it nervous making being with a star?
Yes.
Does it make you go like all limp and everything?
Yeah.
Cool, sit down, quick. and look at this. A real gothic temptress. Oh, please, excuse me. Can we take... Well, just take your lens away. Wait a minute. Can you get up on the... Would you come out here? Just come out here. Because I have to tell you, there is somebody who clearly should have been a contestant in tonight's show. If you would just step this way and turn around so people just come a little further away for me so that everybody can benefit from this wonderful experience that I am having here. May I touch? Oh, look at that. Now, what's your name?
Christina.
Christina, why weren't you on stage?
Oh, I'm much too shy.
Bullshit. How can you be shy? Actually, if this is the definition of shy in Atlanta, then I'm going to stay here. Okay, beautiful. Next year, you promised me you're going to be a part of the show, okay? Okay, well done. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So, now, how do we think the judges are doing? Have you thought which one you would have chosen there?
I have three.
You have three?
Three favorites, yeah.
Oh, if I had three things, I'd be in a circus.
Actually, I'd be very amazed and very interested if you had three names.
Wait, see me afterwards.
All right.
That makes 10 people I'm going to see afterwards. Well, I think I've been incredibly brave coming out and joining you tonight. I am making it back in one piece. I came down to earth for a moment. I came to earth and you were kind to me and I take away fond memories. But now, of course, the whole point of being here tonight is to find out who has won this incredibly prestigious award. So I'm not now entirely in charge of the proceedings, which, as you realize, has been the course of action during the whole evening. I am very proud, I will say, and very touched, because boy was I pissed when I found out the dinner was 1 hour before this show. Like, you know, I didn't get to go, so I am very touched that this beautiful thing is mine. Thank you. So, in the time-honored tradition, in reverse order, with an honorable mention and a very honorable mention, please welcome Dawn Emanuel. It's very exciting back there. And will you present, please? Come up and don't be shy. They're tired now, they can't do anything. They have no staying power, well done. Stay there. Would you like to stand there? And now, third place goes to Trisha Buchwald. Love this look. Here we go. Congratulations, Trisha. Yo. And the second place goes to Amanda Wolf. Yeah. There we go. Wow. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment that we've been waiting for. Please welcome the first place prize winner, Millicent Olvey. Now, congratulations to everybody, ladies and gentlemen. This means that my part of the proceedings are over for this evening. God knows what you are going to get up to, but I would like to thank everybody involved tonight and what's been going on. And finally, I feel that I can say goodnight to you all and thank you for your participation.
Could you have him make a little swing out to the left? Could everybody that steps out swing over to the left and not walk right by the tables? Swing a little further to the left, walk it too close to the table. Can we get a picture? Say, could you have them swing a little farther out to the left? They're walking right by the table. Yeah, the photographers are this way. I like this guy. We're over here.
I'm way over your head.
It's okay.
Is that instructions? Are you blocked something?
Oh, you're mine is zero.
Jacket or no jacket?
Well, that's perfect.
Thank you.
get the door there, just come back.
Hold on, this way?
Right.
Sorry.